Hello, my dear students, and welcome back to our next online English video lecture. And this is not a lecture that I'm not going to teach anything here, but here I'm just going to give you some guidelines for you all that you have already taken a unit test 1 of 30 mark, and it was about 1 hour paper, and I have checked all of your papers. Most of you have written well, and I'm almost satisfied, but I want your performance a little more better, okay? Especially in the area of grammar and writing. Sir, aapka paper to almost check kiya hai, and many of you have done satisfactory, okay? And do area maine aapko aapki jo performance ke liye improvement ke liye jo dekha hai, that is wo hai first one, that is grammar, okay? ग्रामर के बाद जो है राइटिंग से लगे, ग्रामर एकदम परफेक्ट हो गया तो मतलब देन स्पीकिंग एंड राइटिंग थोड़ा बहुत परफेक्ट हो जाएगा, ठीक है? सो इस लेक्चर में हम डिस्कस करेंगे जो हमारा 30 मार्क का जो यूनिट टेस्ट 1 का पूरा पेपर सॉल्यूशन, ओके? सो आई विल गिव यू द क्वेश्चंस हियर ऑन द स्क्रीन डिस्प्लेड हियर, बिकॉज द फर्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज रीडिंग एंड इट कैरीज 8 मार्क. सो बिफोर आई बिगिन डिस्कसिंग ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर unit test 1, I just want to tell you something that is very friendly about your performance, okay? First thing that I really like about you is that many of you have already taken the test. I don't know how many of you have done the test sincerely, but anyway, you have tried, because due to the pandemic COVID-19, you are at home sitting and enjoying the online classes and even your personal time with family and your closed ones, okay? So in this time, you have taken a great initiative to just watch online classes, online lectures, and you have attended almost well, okay? And that is one plus point I really like about you, okay? And you have done this paper because I think you have been attending the unit test and exam papers on this basis, because I have made the paper based on CBSE and NCERT syllabus paper pattern, okay? There is reading section first, then after, you know as it is, okay? Reading and comprehension passage actually. Then after grammar, then writing, and then there is literature, okay? But here, for you, I have not even asked a single question regarding the literature, because I did not give much importance to literature first. There are many stories and poems that we have in our textbook, but everything is important, but now I have not taken, because I just want to test your performance, test your capability and ability, that how far you are able to make sentences, how far you are able to understand what I teach here, okay? Because you are all new to me, okay? And I am also new to you, okay? Sometimes it takes some little bit time to adjust with the teaching style and even the performance of the students that you know very well, okay? Fine, so let's continue with the discussion of the first part, that is reading. And something that I really want to tell you is that you have to improve more on your writing, especially handwriting, okay? एक चीज़ मैंने आपको लेक्चर देते थे तभी भी मैंने आपको बताया था कि कोई भी सेंटेंस नॉर्मली सिंपल सेंटेंस हो तो इधर फुल स्टॉप के साथ या तो क्वेश्चन मार्क तो एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क, मतलब सेंटेंस तो एंड होता है कुछ ना कुछ एक पंक्चुएशन मार्क के साथ, के तो फुल स्टॉप नॉर्मली होता है, ठीक है? एंड कोई स्टूडेंट्स को फुल स्टॉप नहीं लगाया, दूसरे सेंटेंस स्टार्ट किया है, मतलब सेंटेंस का मीनिंग सर को ठीक से नहीं पता चला, ठीक है? ऐसे सेंटेंस में मैंने जस्ट रेड मार्क अंडरलाइन किया है, ठीक है? मार्क तो दिया है नहीं उसके लिए, स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक के लिए एंड ग्रामर मिस्टेक के लिए आई हैव रिड्यूस्ड योर मार्क, ओके? मार्क कम हो गया उसका टेंशन नहीं है, बिकॉज यू आर हियर टू इम्प्रूव, ओके? एंड आई एम हियर टू हेल्प यू मोर, ओके? तो मार्क कम हो गया उसका कोई टेंशन नहीं लेने का, बट आपको पता चलना चाहिए कौन सी एरिया आपका वीकनेस ज़्यादा होता है, वीक है, और उसके ऊपर ज़्यादा फोकस करना होता है, ठीक है? एंड मेरा पर्सनल नंबर सबके पास ऑलरेडी है, ऑल ऑफ यू हैव माय पर्सनल नंबर, ओके? एंड आफ्टर यू सी द चेक द आंसर शीट, यू कैन आस्क मी सम ऑफ द डाउट्स इफ यू हैव स्किल, ओके? फाइन, एंड यू आर ऑलवेज इन गुड कॉन्टैक्ट विद मी एंड आस्किंग सम डाउट्स एंड एवरीथिंग, ओके? Something that I really like about you is that, okay? So without wasting much time, let's directly start with the first part, that is reading, okay? I will display here all the reading procedures and you can read with me, and then after we'll discuss the answer for each question, okay? So let's begin. So you can see the question paper, the reading part that is displayed here on the screen. The first part, that is
reading section. Okay, so it carries 8 mark. Read the passage given below and answer the questions that follow. Okay, so you can just read with me. Okay, let's do this lecture, a kind of discussion on exam paper solution. Okay, modern food has become our enemy. We have become so slavish to taste and presentation that we eat food so for its entertainment value, not for its nutritional benefit. Even as health awareness is increasing, the variety of junk and nutritionless food is also increasing. Each restaurant boasts of a new cuisine, which is a mixture of refined flour, oil, and sugar. Pasta, noodles, white rice, white bread, and maida-based products like pizzas, burgers, naan, and rumali roti are the main options in Italian, Chinese, Indian, or Mexican cuisines. The vegetarian dishes are either overcooked or have a lot of common starch and fat. The non-vegetarian dishes are either white sauce based or made in rich gravies. So here it is all about discussed regarding modern food. Okay, modern food आजकल हमारा जो दुश्मन बन गया है. क्यों? क्योंकि आजकल लोग सबसे ज़्यादा जो टेस्ट के ऊपर प्रेफर करता है rather than nutrition and health. Some of the ingredients are mixture of refined flour, oil, sugar, and it causes lots of damage to our human body. Okay, that's what the sentence is, the paragraph is trying to make us understand. Okay, so my dear students, let's go to the next paragraph. I hope aapke paas shayad printed paper hoga, but still I am giving here displayed just for your easy reading and easy understanding. Okay, so chalo hum abhi next paragraph read karte hain. People are trying to lose weight by eating less in the day so that they can accommodate such foods in the night. They skip breakfast and lunch so that they can satisfy their taste buds in the night with a family dinner. Perfect health, however, cannot be achieved by a process of eating less and not eating. The idea is to nourish the body. You might achieve some weight loss, but you will also lose out on your health. Yeah. So what is the paragraph discussing here? आजकल लोग वेट कम करने के चक्कर में सुबह उठ के थोड़ा बहुत मेहनत करता है, जॉगिंग करता है गार्डन में, एंड इवन अपना सोसाइटी के जो बाहर घूमते रहता है थोड़ा बहुत. एक्चुअली लोग अपना जो बॉडी का वेट कम करने के लिए चाहते हैं, क्योंकि एक्चुअली वेट कम हो जाता है, उसके साथ उन लोगों का हेल्थ भी कम हो जाता है. सुबह थोड़ा नहीं खाता, दोपहर को भी नहीं खाता, लेकिन रात को पेट भर के फैमिली के साथ डिनर खाता है. ठीक है, तो मतलब जिस दिन जितना भी न्यूट्रिशन चाहिए वो पूरा का पूरा एक टाइम में खा के पेट भर देता है. ठीक है, तो उसका नुकसान क्या होता है, यू नो व्हाट इज़ द डिमेरिट ऑफ ईटिंग वन टाइम लॉट ऑफ फूड, व्हाट इज़ दैट? Yeah, it's all about creating more fat inside the body, and it sometimes lose sleep also. ज़्यादातर लोगों को ठीक से नींद भी नहीं आता, ज़्यादातर ज़्यादा खाना खाने की वजह से. ठीक है, तो बॉडी का वेट भी कम कर देता है, लेकिन एक टाइम खाने से ज़्यादा अपने अंदर फैट भी ज़्यादा हो जाता है लोगों का, एंड इवन हेल्थ भी खराब हो जाता है. सो दैट्स अ काइंड ऑफ टेंडेंसी, यू नो दैट, आई थिंक आप लोगों को पता होगा आजकल जो लोगों का टेंडेंसी ज़्यादा है वेट लॉस करना. ठीक है, खाना कम नहीं करता है, एक टाइम में तो तीनों टाइम का एक साथ खा लेता है, बट दे आर नॉट इवन फोकसिंग ऑन द आइडिया टू नरिश द बॉडी. दे जस्ट वांट, दे आर ट्राइंग टू अचीव सम काइंड ऑफ परफेक्शन इन द बॉडी. ओके, नॉट विद द हेल्थ. ओके, सो दैट्स द सेंटेंस इज ट्राइंग टू मेक अस अंडरस्टैंड. चलो लेट्स सी द थर्ड पैराग्राफ is, let's read now. Okay, therefore, whilst embarking upon any weight loss program, remember that health is much more than just weight loss. At the same time, achieving ideal body weight in a healthy way does provide a basis for achieving perfect health. वेट लॉस कम करना एक बड़ा प्रोग्राम नहीं है, बट सबसे ज़्यादा वेट लॉस या कम हो या ज़्यादा हो, सबसे ज़्यादा एक एक्चुअली एक आइडियल बॉडी वेट मेंटेन करना है अगर हेल्थ मेंटेन करना हो तो. दैट्स व्हाट द आइडिया इज डिस्कस्ड इन दिस पैराग्राफ. ओके, सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय डियर फेवरेट स्टूडेंट्स, ओके, सो लेट्स कम टू द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ. So you can just start reading. Our weight is a balancing act, but the equation is simple. If you eat more calories than you burn, spelling mistake, who either burn, okay, you gain weight. And if you eat fewer calories than you burn, then you boom, you lose weight. Okay, so that's also meaningfully correct with the word. Okay, you can just check out the meaning there. Okay, and what is here? There is an balancing act, balancing diet, balanced diet hona chahiye. Okay, aap log to science mein learn karte ho, okay, how to make our body and mind perfect by using balanced diet. And balanced diet mein din mein jo khane ka jo style hota hai, kis tarike se hona hai, wo sab aapne लेन क्या होगा. I think your science teacher has discussed with you about balanced diet, how to maintain health, how to maintain it's sometimes very important to maintain our health and everything that is related to food and exercises. Okay, so let's go to the last paragraph. All too often we make weight loss much more difficult than it needs to be with extreme diets that leave us cranky and starving. Unhealthy lifestyle choices that undermine our dieting efforts and emotional eating habits that stop us before we get started. But there is a better way. You can lose weight without feeling miserable. By making smart choices every day, you can develop new eating habits and preferences that will leave you feeling satisfied and winning the battle of the bulk. Okay, here is the end of reading passage. Okay, so you can just read in mind. Okay, जो आप एक बार जिस बाइक वर्ड करके आप ध्यान से रीड कर सकते हो. ओके, बिकॉज यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन, यू हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन द एग्जाम, सो यू नो द मीनिंग डिस्कस्ड इन दिस पैराग्राफ. ओके, सो मेरे स्टूडेंट्स, चलो अभी हम एक अभी टोटल कितना क्वेश्चन दिया गया है, इसमें 8 क्वेश्चन है, तो हम वन बाई वन डिस्कस करेंगे. ठीक है, हाउ हैज मॉडर्न फूड बिकम आवर एनिमी. इधर थोड़ा भी मोस्ट मिस्टेक किया है स्पेलिंग मॉडर्न. ठीक है, आई होप आपको समझ में आ रहा होगा जिसमें मिस्टेक क्या हुआ था स्पेलिंग में. ठीक है, हाउ डू पीपल ट्राई टू लूज वेट, वाट शुड यू रिमेंबर वाइल ट्राइंग टू लूज वेट, वाट इक्वेशन इज ड्रॉन टू हाईलाइट आवर वेट एज ए बैलेंसिंग एक्ट, वाट इज मेन बाई नरिश. I have given the paragraph number also to just make you feel more easy to find the answer. What is meant by undermine? The answer is given in paragraph number 5. Find the opposite in meaning to happy. The last one is find the word opposite in meaning to neither. Okay, so I will give you the answer displayed here on the screen now. So the first question, that is, how has modern food become our enemy? तो अब ध्यान से बोर्ड जो स्क्रीन में देखे आप आंसर लिख के रखो. द आंसर इज गिवन देयर, एंड ये जरूरी नहीं है आपको सेम टू सेम आंसर एग्जाम में लिखना था. आप लोगों में से काफ़ी स्टूडेंट्स को अपने तरीके से भी सेंटेंस लिखा था, उनके लिए तो भी मैंने मार्क दिया है. ठीक है, स्पेलिंग एंड ग्रामर मिस्टेक के लिए तो मार्क कटा है, बट If you have made your own answers in your own way, then I have given the mark. Okay? But here, ये जो लेक्चर में सर आपके साथ जो सैम्पल आंसर का डिस्कशन कर रहे हैं, इसलिए सर एक मॉडल आंसर इधर दिया गया, दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द कॉम्प्रिहेंशन पैसेज. हाउ हैज मॉडर्न फूड बिकम आवर एनिमी. आप द आंसर स्क्रीन में देखिए, आपकी नोटबुक में लिख के रखो, ठीक है. एंड लिखने के बाद सर का पर्सनल नंबर आपके पास है, तो उस पर्सनल नंबर पर आप लोग जो एग्जाम पेपर सोल्यूशन का आंसर जो भी आपने नोटबुक में अभी लिख रहे हो मुझे सेंड करना, ठीक है. बिकॉज आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू सी वेदर यू आर फॉलोइंग द guidelines or not, how the way you are following. I just want to see. Okay, I hope you have written the first question. And the second question, that is, how do people try to lose weight? How do people try to lose weight? People are trying to lose weight by eating less in the day so that they can accommodate such foods in the night. They skip breakfast and lunch so that they can satisfy their taste buds in the night. And if you have made your own answers without losing the meaning from the passage, then I have given the mark for you all. Okay, I hope you have written the second question's answer also. Then let's come to the third one and fourth one. What should you remember while trying to lose weight? One should remember that health is so much more than just weight loss. At the same time, achieving ideal body weight in a healthy way does provide a basis for achieving perfect health. Okay, you can just look at the screen and write down the answer with its question to your notebook. And the fourth question is, what equation is drawn to highlight our weight as a balancing act? What is the equation? Our weight is as a balancing act. Yeah, if you eat more calories than you burn, you gain weight. And if you eat fewer calories than you burn, you lose weight. So hope you have written the fourth question also with its answer. Okay, and what is the fifth question? E, what is meant by nourish? The answer is given in paragraph number 2. And that is, we have already done the reading practice. Okay, and what is meant by nourish? A feed or foster or nurture. Okay, nurture. Okay, so that's the meaning. You can just write down to your notebook. What is meant by undermine? Undermine means weaken, weaken or demoralize. And find the word opposite in meaning to happy from the fifth paragraph. Miserable. The word is miserable. Okay. And the last one, that is, find the word opposite in meaning to neither. Neither. There is given in paragraph number, paragraph 1. Either. Either. Kabhi kabhi log neither, either pronounce karta hai, but that's not the correct pronunciation. Correct pronunciation ye hai, neither nor either or. Okay. Okay, so you have written, I hope you have written everything, the answers.
Okay, so we have discussed already the first part of the question paper, that was reading section. Okay, and aapko already answer bhi mil gaya hai na. Chalo abhi hum second part mein aayega, that is related to grammar. Okay, thoda bahut grammar ka jo hai, 5 mark ka jo hai grammar ka first question, the second question, that is, and what is it about? Add a noun for each adjective to describe. Okay, so you can see the question paper here. Okay, so grammar section, second question is add a noun for each adjective to describe. Okay, it carries 5 mark. And kaafi students ko bahut acha se kiya hai, it was very nice. Okay, एक नाउन ऐड करना था आपको हर एक वर्ड के लिए. ठीक है, इधर एक मॉडल आंसर आपको मैं दे देता हूँ. ठीक है, एंड यू नो ऑलरेडी इट राइट. एंड द फर्स्ट वन इज ए, ब्यूटीफुल. ब्यूटीफुल के लिए हम क्या क्या नाउन ऐड कर सकता है? व्हाट आर द नाउन्स दैट वी कैन ऐड? ब्यूटीफुल फ्लावर or girl, all these things that we can add for the adjective beautiful. Okay, so that's the first one, beautiful. Okay, add a noun, that was flower or girl, whatever you have written. Okay, agar aapne सही तरीके से जो ब्यूटीफुल कोई भी नाउन के साथ मैच होता है तो आपने लिखा, तो आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन द मार्क. ओके फाइन, एटलीस्ट वन इफ यू हैव रिटन, दैट्स ओके फॉर मी. फाइन, एंड टॉल, बी इज टॉल. टॉल किसके लिए कहता है? टॉल बॉय. और ट्री, okay, and my dear students, you already know what a noun is and what an adjective is. Okay, what is the meaning of noun? Yeah, noun is a naming word that names a person, place, thing, or idea. Okay, that's called noun. And what is adjective? Adjectives are words that describe more about noun, describing word of noun. That's called adjective. Okay, so that's the basic idea. You all know that. Okay, fine. So third one, that word is here, adjective diya gaya, dark. Dark hum kis ke sath use kar sakte hain? Room, color, dark room, dark color. Okay, so you can just copy down these sample answers to your notebook. Okay, and fourth one is green leaf or green vegetable. That's also we can use. Green leaf or green vegetable. Okay, next one is hot sun, hot dish. That's an example we can write as an adjective. Describes about sun, hot dish. And what is the F that is displayed here on the screen? F, purple purple flower, purple dress. And the next one is smooth. What kind of things are smooth? Smooth cloth, and what is the other thing that is smooth? And another one example that we can see, smooth hair. Smooth cloth, smooth hair. Okay, just copy down these semblances to your notebook. Beautiful flower, beautiful girl, then tall boy, tall tree, a dark room, dark color, green leaf, green vegetable, then what is that next? Hot sun, hot dish, purple flower, purple dress, then smooth cloth, smooth hair. Okay, so let's see the remaining words. Yeah, let's see the next one, that is eight, dirty. Okay, dirty room, or dirty shoe. Okay, we can call like that. Next one is happy child, happy student. Who is happy? Okay, happy child, happy student. And the last one is wet floor, wet cloth. Okay, and I hope you know the meaning of wet, means gila hua hai na, opposite is dry. So here, dirty room, dirty shoe, happy child, happy student, wet floor, wet cloth. You see, these are some of the examples that we can use for these describing words that we have seen here. 10 describing words, adjectives, and we have found, we have added noun to each adjective. Okay, fine. I hope this practice was more useful for you to understand the basic concept that is in grammar, noun and adjective. Okay, fine. And if you have given at least one example of a noun for these adjectives, then you would have scored full mark. Okay, fine. So my dear students, I hope this solution is very clear for you. Now you can see the next section, that is writing. Okay, you can see here on the board, writing. That is the third question. Let's discuss on the third question now. Okay, so my dear students, let's come to the third question, that is writing part. Okay. And I have already told you in the beginning the story and the लेक्चर की स्टार्टिंग में मैंने आपको कहा था कि एक चीज पे आपको बहुत ज्यादा फोकस करना है, दैट इज राइटिंग. एंड यू हैव मेनी आइडियाज एंड यू आर टैलेंटेड स्टूडेंट्स, माय स्मार्ट स्टूडेंट्स एंड टैलेंटेड स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव मेनी आइडियाज. सो ओनली वन थिंग दैट यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन टू इम्प्लीमेंट योर आइडियाज विदाउट ग्रामेटिकल मिस्टेक्स यूजिंग गुड वोकैबुलरीज एंड करेक्ट सेंटेंसेस, द नीड यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन, दैट इज वेयर यू हैव टू मोर फोकस ऑन इम्प्रूविंग हैंड राइटिंग, इम्प्रूविंग राइटिंग स्किल्स and even handwriting also very important. Okay. So the third question, that is what? Third question kya hai? Use comparative adjectives to make sentences. Comparative adjectives is a sentence banana. Okay. You can see here, that is broad, broader, heavy, heavier, dark, darker, good, better, prettier, prettiest. Okay. So let's use at least one word in a sentence. Let's take broad. The state highways, you can write down to your notebook, okay? The state highways are broader than local roads. Okay, write down this sentence, this sample sentence to your notebook. The state highways are broader. Broader means there is more space. It's wide, wider. Okay. The state highways are broader than local roads. Okay, just write down this to your notebook. Yeah, and the second one, we can take the word we can use both heavy and heavier both in one sentence. Okay, it is a heavy table. It is a heavy table means it's a positive comparison, positive degree, yeah? And comparison degree is heavy, heavier. Okay, it is a heavy table. This table is heavier than my old table. This table is heavier means here there is a comparison between two, this table and my old table, means there are two tables and each table both heavy, both more than heavy than the old table. Okay, this table is heavier than my all table. Okay, so this is one example sentence for you. You can just write down in your notebook. Okay, so let's come to the third sentence, that is dark, darker. Yeah, let's make one sentence with darker comparison. Our bedroom is darker than living room. You can make comparison between any two, okay? But here I am giving you only a sample sentence. Our bedroom is darker than living room. Let's see the next word, better. She sings better than me. It's a comparison between two, she and me. Okay, comparison between two, that is comparison, comparative, positive, comparative, and superlative. Okay, and I hope you know the difference between these three comparisons. Okay, so here is better than, means talks about comparison, means discussing the comparison on the quality of singing. Yeah, let's see the last one, that is prettier, prettiest. And let's take the word prettiest. Prettiest means both are long say ek sabse acha hai. And here the word is prettiest for superlative degree, means sabse acha. The prettiest meaning is most beautiful, sabse zyada khoobsurat. Okay, she is the prettiest woman in our team. I have sample sentence to use. Prettiest means बहुत सारा लोग है, बहुत सारा वुमेन है, ठीक है? तो उसमें से एक जो गर्ल के इधर आपको मेंशन करना है तो नाम मेंशन कर सकते हैं, बट हियर आई एम गिविंग यू ओनली प्रोनाउन, रिलेटिव प्रोनाउन शी. ठीक, तो सभी में से बहुत खूबसूरत है, ठीक है? प्रेटियस्ट, शी इज द प्रेटियस्ट. ओके, एंड आई होप यू नो द रूल दैट आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस विद यू इन सम ऑफ द अर्लीस्ट लेक्चर्स. ओके, एंड व्हाट इज दैट, एंड द definite article has to be placed before the superlative degree. कोई भी superlative degree use करना है तो हम the article use करना जरूरी है. The prettiest, okay? The heaviest, the darkest, the best, the prettiest. So these are some of the examples. Okay? She is the prettiest woman in the or in our team. Okay, so you can just copy down this to your notebook. Okay, so hope you understood the discussion on this third question. Comparative adjectives to make sentences. Okay, so if you have done this work, then you would have scored 5 marks. Okay, so this is clear to you. Now let's come to the fourth question. And what is the fourth question? Make sentences using the following words. So now let's come to the fourth question. Okay. What is the fourth question? Make you sentences using the following words. Okay. What is the first word? Freedom. Okay. So I will give you one sample sentence here, and you can make your own sentences. But here, just one example sentence I will give you here, written on the board. You can just copy down to your notebook. Okay. Freedom. We remember and pay homage. We remember and pay homage to our freedom fighters We remember and pay homage to our freedom fighters especially on the Independence Day. Especially on the Independence Day. Okay, you can write down this. And here the word is used, freedom, okay? So let's see the next word, that is justice. What's the meaning of justice in Hindi? Kya bolte hai justice ko? Niti, hai na? Niti. Let's make one sentence. We must treat everyone with justice. Okay, you can write down this example to your notebook. We must treat everyone with justice. So many of you have written good sentences, and some of you have to improve more regarding sentence making practice. Okay, you have to practice more. Okay, so this section is very clear to you. Now let's go to the third word, friendship. Yeah, anyway, let's see the word friendship in a sentence, okay? It is always good to maintain good friendships it is always good to maintain good friendships okay achievement Let's see the next word. My parents congratulated me on my achievement. My parents congratulated me on my achievement. On my achievement. Okay. And किसी किसी का sentence तो सही था, but ये जो word achievement का spelling आप इधर आपको देखने के लिए मिल रहे हैं, एंड इवन क्वेश्चन पेपर में भी आपको देखे लिखना था, ठीक है। अगर ऐसा कोई सेंटेंस में स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक किया है जो वर्ड ऑलरेडी क्वेश्चन पेपर में है, तो वो सेंटेंस के लिए बिल्कुल मार्क नहीं दिया था, ठीक है। मतलब इतना केयरलेसली एग्जाम लिखेगा तो मतलब व्हाट विल बी, व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन विद यू। सो यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन द स्पेलिंग, ठीक है। एंड इफ यू आर राइटिंग सम न्यू वर्ड, इफ देयर इज लिटिल बिट मिस्टेक्स इन दैट, देन आई कैन जस्ट टॉलरेट विद दैट, ओके। But if the spelling is there, the sentence is there with correct spelling in the question paper, then you have to repeat that same, okay? Maybe some spelling mistakes is there in the spelling in the question paper. For writing, reading practice में थोड़ा spelling mistake था, तो मैंने आपको बताया था वो, ठीक है? And that was due to the typing mistakes that you can, I hope you understand that, okay? Very good. So, let's come to the next word, that is remember. Remember. Okay, next word is remember. Remember means याद करना, ठीक है। And the word मैंने already आपको first जो sentence में दिया था ना, remember. Okay, let's see one example with remember. We must remember the people who help us in difficult times. Yeah, we must remember the people who help us in difficult times, okay? You can write down that word. And let's see the next word, increasing. Nowadays, pollution is increasing day by day. Nowadays, pollution is increasing day by day. Can write down this sentence to your notebook. Nowadays, pollution is increasing day by day. And the word maintain, that is also I have given in the third sentence, friendship. Okay? We must maintain good friendship. Okay? So I hope that you can just copy down, or if you want, you can make your own sentence with maintain. Okay? We must maintain our health. We must maintain our health. Maintain health, maintain body, maintain good atmosphere. Maintain good atmosphere to make us more, to live more and to live happy, to live long. Okay, so that's some examples you can make in your own way. Okay? So my dear students, now the fourth question discussion is over. Now we are going to discuss the fifth one, that is paragraph writing on value of discipline. Okay. Okay, so we are going to the last one, that is value of discipline. That is, you know already that I have given you an example in the lecture number, I think it was lecture number 16. Lecture number 16 में मैंने आपको पूरा का पूरा पूरा lecture actually value of discipline के बारे में दिया है, ठीक है, तो आप उसमें चेक कर सकते हो, ठीक है. That is the answer for the last question, okay. तो फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन का जो आंसर है, जो आप वैल्यू ऑफ डिसिप्लिन, राइट. वैल्यू ऑफ डिसिप्लिन के I think the lecture I have explained this is 16 lecture, okay. इसमें आपने already check भी किया होगा, ठीक है. 16 lecture में आपको इसका आंसर मिलेगा, ठीक है. काफ़ी स्टूडेंट्स अपना तरीके से भी सेंटेंस बनाए, मार्क तो दिया है सर ऑलरेडी, ठीक है. सो एनी वे इट वॉज नाइस एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टोटली डिस्कस ऑल द क्वेश्चन दैट वॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन लेक्चर यूनिट टेस्ट 1 ऑन 7th डेट ऑफ September, okay. So I hope you understood everything and आपके एक homework भी है जो मैंने आपको कहा था, पूरा का पूरा जो lecture के जो solution जो हमने discuss किया वो आप answer के साथ notebook में लिख के सर के personal number पे share करना, ठीक है. And you know already my personal number and everything, ठीक. So आप safe रहो घर पे, stay home, stay safe, be happy and always keep smiling.